This walk is devoted to using the building function of Microsoft Excel. Create a new document or sheet on an existing document. Name it accordingly. So this is task 4. Select all cells, change the size to 15 centimeters. And rewrite the assignment completely. So just type for, no, I'm just copy and paste from our references. So I just retype all this task from these two pages in our Microsoft Excel document. I just skip this process. So the document is as follows. The highlighted cells will have to contain formulas with built-in function. So determine whether the number is odd or even. So use function if and use function mod. To simplify our task, the nearest cell of this work, open up your insert function panel and find in all category function mod. When you select this function, we see the help, or just press help on the function to open the tutorial from Microsoft Excel. Mod, press OK. Select the number, the cells with this value. Divisor 2. So how this function works? If 6 division by 2, no fractional part, then we see 0. If 5 division by 2 have fractional part, then this function shows 1. So just copy this function in this area, insert if function. If this is true, then this is odd. It's not true, then even. Press OK. Then just check how the features work. 10 even, 5 odd. So our just delete auxiliary cell. Next part of our task, calculate the arithmetic mean of an array of this value using function sum. So select these cells, find functions of sum and just press enter key. In the formula bar we see this is our sum. How to obtain arithmetical mean of this array? Just delete the count of numbers. So delete and insert new function count. In count function select these numbers, count numbers 15 and press OK. That's all. Next part, using the average function to calculate arithmetic mean. So select these cells, open insert function dialog and find average function and just select numbers to calculate arithmetic mean and just press OK. This value is equal. Next our task, count the numbers of zero in this column. Use COUNTIF function. Select cell, open insert function menu, find COUNTIF function, in range select numbers, in criteria type 0, press OK. Next task, find the maximum number in the array, use the maxa function, select cells, find and insert function maxa and just select these numbers, press OK. So maximum numbers is 123. Next, solve quadratic equation of the form x square plus by x minus c equals 0. So to insert this image, just open your Microsoft Word, and use insert table to create equation and just type it x bx c 0 and like this. Control C to copy it or just copy and Control V to paste. We obtain this equation as raster image. In the same way we obtain other equations. So we need to find first the discriminant value by this formula. So double click on these cells to activate it and begin our form from equals. Next B shift 6 to minus 4 multiply A and just enter it and multiply to C. This is our formula. This is our value of discriminant. So next, use if function to analyze how many roots we have. So select choose if function and if our discriminant bigger than 0, then we have two roots on this equation. But in this we have only one value, but roots may be one roots or no roots if discriminant smaller than 0. So one more time use one more time, use if function this cells equals zero, then one root, and else no roots. Then press OK. So we see this if bulletin function inside of another if bulletin function. So check how does it work. If d minus 5, for example, we have no roots. Control Z to undo. If d 0, we have only one roots. And any values of plus sign, we have two roots. That's work. So next, we need to use if function to find roots 1 and roots 2. So create if function. If this cells value no roots, then in this cell we need to see no roots. Else find by this equation first roots, so minus b plus squared of d by 2 multiply a and just press OK. That's all for roots, for first root. Second root. I just copy this equation and paste it here. Open. If this value two roots, we need to find second root by formula with minus squared, and in other we see no roots text. So one more time, check how does it work. If minus 5 we see in all cells no roots, if 0 one root, and if plus value we see all two roots. That's all. Next, we need to create three tables and fill a table of salary first. To obtain value with sign of monetary units, just select the cell, press Ctrl 1, find in number tal currency, and use Russian values of monetary units. Then Press OK. So, in this table of payroll, full name from salary table. So, equals Ivanov from salary table. Just select and after fill it. In the same way, in second timesheet table, fill the name cells from salary table. Salary from salary table equals enter and just after fill it. So miss it. Insert table. Find total and use count black function find count blank function and select this row. Press OK and just after fill it. So work it out from timesheet table. This is our total value of timesheet. After fill these values. Missed days per month minus work it out. If you use after fill, we see not correct value. So, double click to edit it and freeze with this sign, use relative addressing of the cells and just after fill it. On hand equals salary, delete day per month, multiply, work it out. One more time. Use relative addressing to use day per month values. And after that, just after fill it. So, our work is complete. Don't forget to save your work. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.